They're tiny and precious, and they can't tell you when something's wrong. So when your baby is sick, you need to trust that the doctor can recognize what's going on and how to treat it. Now doctors have a new tool to train them to do just that. This may look like a baby, but this little one is all AI.
Which, of course, means artificial intelligence. Thank you so much for sticking with us, because this is really fascinating. Right now, Mike Kirk of Nemours Children's Hospital, he's a paramedic, and Jim Archetto, he is from Gaumard Scientific. They are behind this baby simulator and here to show us how it works. Thank you, gentlemen, both for being here. All right, so this is fascinating. So it truly is one of the most frustrating things for a parent. The baby cries, and they're trying to figure out hungry, tired, wet diaper, something wrong, sick, right? Mm-hmm. All of the things that we don't know, and doctors have that same issue. Is that right?
Correct.
Yeah.
You know, when you get a child that's sick, trying to figure out what's making them sick can be very difficult to do.
Yeah.
So having realistic training devices that we can mimic realistic symptoms, signs, presentations that the kids make are really, really important when we're training them and working with them, even after they're through their initial training.
All right. So Jim, tell me a little bit about this idea to come up with an artificial intelligence baby to help people train with, right?
The objective is to ensure that Mike and his team, physicians, nurses, first responders, have everything they need. So when a real patient comes into their hospital or their ambulance, they're prepared for it. So what's a better way to train than on something such as Super Tory here? The problem in the challenge is getting her to be as realistic as possible. And that's what we do. You'll notice, Amy, she's not plugged in right now. She's completely wireless, and I'm controlling her with this tablet. So I can present any clinical condition that Mike wants to train his team on
from
this tablet.
All right, so let's demonstrate and show our audience how this works. And do you want to put the baby down, Mike, or is it easier
we'll
to hold
down.
It? Okay. All right.
You can see that she's breathing
She's very lifelike, too. Yes. Yeah. Look at that. Okay, Ephraim's going to have to kind of zoom in to see that. But yeah, look at that. See, her chest is moving up and down. That's truly amazing.
And you can see that these ports here, these are used for real equipment. So when Mike is working with his team, he doesn't have to say, well, pretend she was hooked up to an EKG. He hooks her up to a real EKG machine.
Wow.
And she has software and hardware inside that sends signals to that EKG machine, so it can be very realistic.
Okay, this is really, really fascinating. Okay, so can we demonstrate, Jim, and show the audience some of the things that she can do?
So you can see the chest rising and falling now.
Okay.
One of the common tests that physicians perform and Mike will perform with his team is called capillary refill time. They want to ensure that blood is getting to the extremities.
Okay.
So what Mike's going to do is pinch her left foot.
Okay.
And what you're going to see is it change color.
Okay,
sure.
Just put your thumb right there.
All right.
And squeeze.
Okay.
And you're going to see that in a real child, the skin would let go.
Okay.
You'd see the skin blanches out. It sort of pushes the blood away from that area. And then when we let it go, we count 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 1,000, 5. And however many seconds it takes tells us what their capillary refill time. And that tells us how well the child's perfusing. If for 1-2 seconds, that's ideal. You know, the child's perfusing very well. If it's 3, 4, 5 seconds, it means the child's not perfusing very well.
And what do you mean by perfusing, Mike?
Getting blood circulation.
Okay.
So what happens is that when children get sick, they start to shift the blood flow from the extremities to keep it to the central core.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why using capillary refills are very important.
That's fascinating.
Assessment tool. And we don't have to have a fancy device. We don't have to do any lab tests. It's something that we can do right on the child right there.
Wow. Okay. And you guys told me earlier, you can make her cry,
We can make her do all sorts of things, sure. And one of the challenges that Mike and his team face is IVs. Now as adults, it's
pretty
easy to get an IV.
Yeah.
But you can see she has tiny little veins here.
Yep.
But one of the ways they access is notice her umbilical cord here and how realistic that is.
Oh, yeah.
So Mike could actually put a catheter into that umbilical cord. And we have simulated blood, and Mike can use that to train his team as well.
Right.
Look at that. That's amazing. That's truly, isn't it the worst when you have a child and you can't find the vein and you have to do multiple? It's just it's so painful as a physician or a nurse or a paramedic.
Yeah.
And what this is all designed, developed, and manufactured right here in Florida, Amy.
Wow.
So we're based in Miami, Florida.
Uh-huh.
We have engineers, manufacturing engineers, development engineers, and electrical engineers. And what we do is we start from the outside and work inward. This has to look and perform and act and move and cry like a regular baby does. So we work with physicians who say this is what a baby does and this is how she acts. And then we start trying to fit everything inside.
That's fascinating.
all of those things.
If our viewers have questions or would like more information, where should they go?
Sure. They can send a message to check our website at Gaumard.com, G-A-U-M-A-R-D.com.
All right, fabulous. And, of course, you can always go to the Nemours website, too. We're out of time. Is there one more thing you want to show me?
So this is actually, if we have problems finding IVs, we'll use scalp veins. And so this is actually a area where we can actually insert a scalp, an IV at the scalp as well.
Fascinating. All right, can you make her cry before we send her to Jamie?
Yeah, let's see.
We'll see if she'll cooperate.
Let's see. Yeah, she's not cooperating today.
Oh, darn. That's okay. Yeah. Jamie, we don't want to make the baby cry.
Right.
I feel bad. Let's cover her up. She looks cold.
You get me all ruffled up before the weather. It's never good.